Hello everyone, my name is Chris and welcome to a new video called Epic Fail to Win Pro Moments. In this compilation I have put clips together where certain pro players and full teams completely turned around unwinnable situations such as 2v5s, 1v5s and so on. Huge thanks to Snipe2DieTV who has helped me out collecting the clips. Check him out, his link is in the description. But for now, enjoy the video guys.
And which is actually real interesting here. It's like more of a defaulty type of playstyle.
Oh, that entrance from Freiburg. He is supposed to be the main entry fragger, and that was obviously beautiful. And he's going to take down Glaive as well. That's a stunning triple kill. Christopher is going to be taken down. Carry, that's Get Right over there. And now, well, Cadian's, it's a nice kill on Fiflaren, and he's controlling the bomb. But what do you think? Is he going to be able to hold on to this?
I don't think he's going to hold on to it. I think they're just going to swarm them together. Okay. And if he does, that will be really insane.
That would be.
But they actually picked it up, so now they're just going to retreat. Watching his back as every 2 seconds.
Yeah. Which you should do against Get Right.
Because, yeah, you never know when a wall Get Right is going to hit you on your screen.
So coming to your third kill coming in here, and he's going to try and flash his way into the bombs. Actually, they're so far away, he has a kit as well. Get the pun in the corner. He thinks they're still in here. He's going to get the kill. He could seriously go for the defuse. Oh my god, Cadian, he just wins the round!
He just won a 1v5.
That is genius, absolutely genius.
That was crazy.
Now you could hear the shout, I don't know if you guys in the audience could, but we could hear Cadian.
It's just going to come down to who's actually able to get more than one CT-sided round.
What?!
And look at the lineup, Fugly's got four, trying to go for the ace. That final player, not going to be over there though for him to grab. That is going to be Shazam. Shazam hits the op shot. Shazam hits a pistol shot right after that. But he is going to be 1v3. And he does have full HP. He almost just made that 1v2.
What the heck was that, Fugly? It's a 4K. He just needs one more for the ace. Misses the opportunity. Shazam out offs him.
Shazam, pressure's on. Look at this trap. He's able to pick up the bomb. Backing off, 27 seconds. He has to commit to B-side.
Yeah, he did. Man, this is a tough spot to be in here. Time, ticky low. Gonna grab the bomb. They're just gonna try and wait it out. They're gonna try and take him. He's gonna do the sound fake first. Fires off an op shot. Now he's gonna go to safety. Gonna put the bomb down. Now they know for a fact. He hits the first shot. He could be able to get this. He's got himself 4K. Does he get
nice.
The ace? He got the ace clutch. Shazam
is
done.
Look at him.
Ace clutch for Shazam. What a beautiful play comes out.
Magic moving up very aggressively here. He's got the 5-7 in hand, walking right into Taz on the other side. Grenade was followed up there. It's going to be the headshot to start off. That's a really nice start. And more aggression coming out. Cajun dropping one, leaving a trapped Neo over along with the bomb. Snack's going to be going down. What are we witnessing now? Neo, the last one left. You know, 1-on-4. Dignitas deciding. It is not over yet. They want to fight and they want to continue to battle into overtime. And the money for Virtus Pro is they lose this round, which it certainly feels like they will. They're going to have just as bad a situation as Dignitas just did.
I'm so surprised that Dignitas got away with that. They've done this before with assault rifles. VP were just sat in positions where no one was watching the fountain. Neo very nearly lands a second one. Will through the wall. And now with this smoke, he can get the bomb planted. The problem is, Dignitas have a lot of grenades still at their disposal. Kevlar and AKs.
They have 2 smokes left, and that's a really big problem for Neo because he has a Molotov, and I bet he would love to use it to buy time, but they've already smoked out the bomb. There's another headshot coming through. He'd have to go for the ace clutch into winning the semifinals here, looking for another spray. Neo's going to get it. He goes for more. Spray for the one. He's out of bullets. Neo! Are you kidding me? He picks it up. Ace clutch right into the grand finals.
Make it happen. 21 seconds to go. Time's still ticking away, and he's trying to get something done here, but the second that he goes for that plan, the second he makes noise, he's gonna be destroyed. He gets one frag, but oh, Peter missing that shot, and that might allow him to get the bomb down.
At the very least, he's gonna complete that task, so the bomb goes out on the ground, guarantees him the extra money. Now he's gonna try to win this out while only having the statue position. There's
no
one.
No way.
He's done these before. This could be an ace as well. There's the flick for number four and number five. Disco Doblin does it again as a massive clutch is pulled up from him.
Havoc's crosshairs, and he will pick up the frag. A 1v3 for Anger. There's the first one. There's the second one. 10 seconds to play with. Yam just has to play the time. 8 seconds. Anger, go for the bomb. You can't afford to go and look for him here. And he's timed himself out. He is not going to get this one. Oh, he still gets the kill.
What
did I just witness, Yam? Is this real life?
Dupree, he's in jungle, yes, but at this point, I think it's better to just walk away from this kind of a fight here. 2v4, save the weapons.
The bomb's not down yet. Dupree can go for something, and Pionic's gonna give it to him. This isn't great discipline. Dupree puts him right back into this round. It's a 2-on-2. Mistakes from Virtus Pro. They cannot afford to make them. And Zipnik's again that shot onto Taz.
What in God's name is happening? Dupree picks up the third one there. They turn it almost effortlessly from a 2-on-4 into a win.
Bodic's been waiting for the rotation all this time. I don't think Forrest saw his opponent through the flames there, as can often happen. Coming in for... Oh, Forrest, that's disgusting! Both at the same time, and he's got a kit. That is grotesque. I didn't even know what to say. Man. That was nasty. That was nasty stuff.
Yeah, Finesse is going to be the linchpin in this one. Coming in from the back, coming in with the kit, with the utility as well. Now CZ's. When this smoke, or when this Molotov goes out, it's time for the push.
It's all on Makalele, 1v3, tapping away. Ricky snuffs him out, and CLG, they will pick this up. 16-12, they win out the series in a 2-1 fashion. It was lengthy,
no,
but it was...
No, no, no! Oh!
There was no time!
No! You saw it, they even left the server! Michael Ellie and Rusty disconnected!
What? FNS! He was gutted! What just happened?
What? Michael Ellie's confused!
He's
we're
like,
going back in!
He's like, I better plug everything back in,
we're
boys!
We're going back in, boys!
One more time into the simulation! even the producers were confused.
Yeah,
they started
yeah.
playing the victory music. Let's go! This isn't over yet. We can still see some more overtime come out of this.
Yep.
Don't do anything just yet. The bomb, not down. Red Reserve first have to try and deal with that beast, but as FNS goes down, it will be the 2-on-4 in the retake. And that's it. It's going to be over in the blink of an eye. Red Reserve win this out. CLG. Hang on a minute. This is fantastic.
What a game.
When your series ends, with this as your finishing song. There we go.
As they gravitate towards the A site, this is going to be hard. Flamey's been doing big stuff, so Simple needs to deliver as well as they start to bring in the pain from Connector.
Simple, can he face in time? The bomb's getting planted. He's got it down, man. They're going to win the round. They've stolen it from the clutches of defeat. That is disgusting.
Now there's only 25 seconds. He has to go and pick up that bomb. He's got it now. Device putting a couple of bullets through. Just one bullet will take care of the finished player. And now Device going to be sneaking in. He's ready and waiting for Arlo to walk out. He's just crouching behind here. Look at the mind game that's going on. It's been going on for more than 20 seconds now. Device going to go for it. He can't hit the shot. Arlo's still on the other side. One headshot is all it's going to take. Device now getting close. He's down to 28 and he goes down. Arlo picks it up. What a win!
As we can see, trying to make his way up slope. Will set it up for his mate to get through onto that site, get that bomb plant perhaps. Kenny, though, needs to find the kill, and he misses the shot. And that isn't going to help. Misses the follow-up as well. They're going to start closing in on him like sharks. He spots the man, misses a third, and now they're on top of him. If he commits that bomb plant, he is not lit.
What?
Not even Maniac knows what to say there.
Here. He can stake the round for Liquid. There's the first frag. No silencer there. Announcing himself. Can't quite finish off Taco. Great response coming in from Quad. Although Taco's down to 3 HP. Giving Liquid a chance, is Alige, in retaking this. There's the incendiary. He's going to actually whiff that one. In goes Simple. Up the ladder. Fallen taking down a Dren. This is looking very hard right now for Liquid to get in here. Fallen, though, whiffing a shot. There's the second, though. Now, again, as we've seen so many times before, it's down to Hiko, but against four, is it really possible? We do have a few players quite tagged up here from Luminosity, so Hiko definitely not going down without a fight. Oh, wow, there's the first fast frag. Hiko gets a double. There's still two players left. They got no health on them. 13 and three. Hiko creeping around the site now. There's still time. Oh my goodness, how does he do this? How does Hiko do it again?
Clean sheet remains for Liquid. Luminosity yet to find a round. Hiko is the clutch god of Counter-Strike, surely.
But CLG, they're pushing forward. They can find something here.
It's going to be Cutler that rounds out. He finds two kills back to back, but he gets caught trying to trade out a gun. Fugly finding another one. Jason R trades it back. And now it's Summit in the 1v1 to try and close this out against Fugly. Fugly playing it aggressively. No, but Summit's going to clutch it. And Slice will close out map number one, 16-11. Oh, wait. What?
Okay, then.
No! What happened? Oh no! Summit! No!
Oh, that is heartbreaking.
And Songer is putting a shot through, manages to connect with one. That's Dupree down to 38. But they are going to get control of this A site, Team Dignitas. They've got the smokes down to cut Cloud9 off. And in fact, they're going for huge plays! Dupree! Triple spray runs through the smoke into CPL. And that shatters the defense. Cloud9 in a 2-on-4.
That bomb plant's already been happening for quite a while here. So Hiko and Sean, that's a good kill from Hiko, but they realize Dupree's still in there somewhere. They're gonna try and go for it here. They wanna go all in. Hiko comes in with another kill. And back to a 2-on-2. That bomb's so far ticked. They gotta move quick right now. They're going for it. The defuse is already happening. Hiko, are you kidding me? He's gonna go for it. They win the round. Hiko picks up a triple and Cloud9 win it. What?
That push in to kill Snacks, I mean, that lost them the AWP, and they just have nothing now, though. A great pickup from Smith. He's going to get a double. Oh my god, triple. All headshots except for Neo, and that's going to be incredible. Pistols apparently are enough. Existence with another kill, and now it's on Snacks here. 1-on-3, saving Virtus Pro from potentially a very embarrassing round.
Oh, this is scary now. He is. I mean, this is still feasible here for Snacks. Good little corner jump there to get back up, and he's going to have the nade for Smiths.
What?
What
HP?
Oh my god.
Welcome to CSGO.
Oh man, that nade should have done it. That should have been a 1v1. Oh, Snacks, no.
That is incredible. I did not see how close that landed, but it must have been incredibly close. Well, he's going to finish it with the AK. He's looking for the ace. He gets the ace. Wow. Snacks kills every single member of Titan and Virtus Pro. Now to... You got your whiz, 10-5 for the Polish team. They get that, but...
Up in the vents is going to be able to take out Cajun, and then they still need to find Flamey. They still don't know where that guy is. Device takes out Edward. Zipnix missing a bit of an opportunity, looking for the shot. Zeus, though, not going to give it to him. Zipnix would just, like, he would sell his mom right now if he could have just wallbanged that.
Look how close they are. It's an awful thought, but not going to be good enough here. Seize picks up one. Sibnix finds a double. Missing the shotgun. He gets out. Oh, no. Sibnix picks up the kill. How did Navi lose this round? Semler, that one, and the Tech 9 rush towards B. Navi are going to be hating themselves if they end up losing this game.
Picked up the MP7 that Skadoodle dropped early on, but he won't get any further than that. He will not get a bomb plant down. Cold's just fighting at this point to try and salvage the round. There's no way Plant is in mind. It's all about kills. It's a 1v2. Knows one's close as well based on the nade. Doesn't really have the range. The CZ has the accuracy. Oh, oh! He gets off with Cold Zero! What a way to start off for SK as they tie it 1-1.
He's got the CZ as well. I think he knows where they both are. He's just seen Kerrigan run away, and he must be able to guess where Cajun is. He must have heard the shots behind him.
Oh, with 15 seconds to go, he's got to pick up some pace. He's got to hope for this 1v1 up against Kerrigan, then get the bomb down thereafter. This is going to be very difficult. He doesn't have like any time to work with. The bomb plant's going to take 5 seconds alone. He's going to go for it behind the fountain. Kerrigan's just going to charge him down. He's going to miss quite a few pistol shots. Kenny S, he picks up the kill. Kerrigan should not have put that. He gets the second. Kenny S clutches the round.
Oh, I don't think that you can really be allowed to miss that many shots, but Royce is there and he's actually trying to reposition here. So Oscar can get into another engagement, can get a reload in as well. So still a chance here. I mean, we can't put it past the likes of Oscar and Rops to do something here. Nade thrown in by Oscar as he sees all the players going in towards the bomb site. Rops is appearing as well. And Oscar's got a good angle. Rops gets another kill.
Boy.
All of a sudden, surely not. Oh my goodness. Oscar with another kill. And it's a 2v1. It was 2v5. They've yet to lose a man. And Pronax is the last man standing. Goes for one. He'll get it against Oscar. But still, 40 seconds to go. Rops is creeping in. And there it is.
The floodgates haven't been opened just yet. But SK at least will get onto the site and get the bomb planted and put the pressure now in the hands of Mouse Sports. That looked like it was very close to landing, and I think Fallen even assumed that was the case as well. But after he's missed that shot, that could be the difference maker here in this round. Dennis is spamming up through the bench, leaving Caldera in a 1-on-4. There's the first. Looking for a second, he connects it. Oh, and he gets a third as well. Surely he's not going to pull this one off. Oh, Caldera, the man, the myth, the beast. What a play.
Once, I'd say there's a decent chance now we're going to check this. I'm not a big fan of it. Well, we'll see. They are pushing up, and he just goes for it. Aggressively sprays down two, and that is huge. Well played, Sean. Sees they're going to be able to take him down, and then Flamey returns with a double of his own. It's a 2v2, and Flamey gets a triple kill, and now it's all on Shroud here. 17 seconds, and he goes for the fight. He goes down, and Na'Vi are going to win it 16-14, and you can tell the impact on Cloud9 there. Oh, wow. What a game this has turned out to be. Huge
legendary
victory for
Na'Vi. That's legendary.
It's dangerously close for both teams here. VP have got to be sweating a little bit, but with that kind of opening into pre-burning alive and Pasha opening up on Cajun, it seems like it's finally time for the Polish team to get back in the game. Sipnix and Device are left, and I don't see a way out of this. Pasha caught sleeping a bit, and Sipnix getting one and two, another headshot. He escapes back through the smoke, and there still is no bomb plant. He hasn't reloaded yet, but the bomb is trapped in the middle. There should be no way for TSM to get back in a 2v5, but Sipnix has bought them a tiny opening once again, and Device is on full health. And in this A-bomb side, if they sneak in, they don't check this corner. This could be the losing round here for VP that they just cannot recover from mentally. It must be a huge blow if it happens. Device, he's just staying put. They've got no grenades. They can't smoke off for the plant either. Neo putting it down safely, so Device can't punish it, but he's going to be looking over the box for a moment, and now he gets the chance. Neo goes down, and from a 2v5 into a 2v2 now. Sipnix coming in from Kitchen, and snacks his sandwich. He's looking for the headshot. He's missing, and Sipnix is going to be right behind him. It's a question of timing. Sipnix gets the third kill of the round. It could be happening. Taz is all alone. He can't stop the plan. There's no way in. Oh my god, TSM, they're going to get the round. Sipnix, quad kill, and that might be the grand finals here. 14 rounds for TSM.
He did his job, Pasha. That's all that matters. He got two kills, and now that sets it up perfectly for his teammates. As Getright will walk right into Bialy, get that kill, brings it back to a 2-on-3. Nades are going to sail in on that defuse as well, and there's Getright getting another. Fifth Lauren has to get in here and stop this defuse, and he just barely does. It's a 1-on-1 now, and Getright versus Snax. And who better to have than Getright to do the job?
He's still defusing. He's going to nerf him. Getright, no! Virtus Pro win the round. Oh god, that was so close. But a triple kill from Getright is not enough, even with the knife. Virtus Pro, they take that round. What an incredible turn of events.